quite similar to the helpline. Just engaging, building up rapport, just getting trust, you know, just letting them know that you're a real person and that you're there to help them and listen to them and not judge. So it's really just building up that contact and then finding out, you know, what is it that I can help you with, or what is it that you want to do, or where do you want to go, and what can we do to help you? I guess to begin with, it's just listening and trying to get through that, okay, it isn't the end of the world. There is support, there is help, and people overcome it. And that's the main facts that I focus on to begin with, that once I've sort of let their story out, that it isn't the end of the world. We just work with the client, you know, what suits them. Some people might go, I only want once a week. Other people, it might be, I need just a bit of support to get me through the initial detox and the first few days. And also sort of patterns are that sometimes they'll be fine for a couple of months. Just starting to think, oh, it might be time to let them go, and wow, you know, struggling. So relapse prevention might come in again, that we have to call every second day. A lot of the time, consumed others forget to look after themselves and they're too busy trying to fix this other person. So actually reflecting back onto them to actually look after number one, you know, put boundaries in place, take some time out, and then take some steps from there. And that can be quite a big change around for them. I must say, you know, stopping it for most people, they kind of go through that on a regular basis if they don't use for 2 or 3 days, because it is out of the system, sort of 72 hours. And they're coming down, you know. Other people who are chronic daily, say IV users, that is quite a bit different. And sometimes people can just stop, feel fine in 3 days and back to normal. Other people, they may have to go to a detox. And then sometimes that's about being in a safe environment, where they live or whatever may not be safe for them to do that. So there are options. That's the great thing. There are options. There's that thing about hope, is don't give up. You know, that people do feel, especially meth, you know, with the mood issues and the coming down, it's really easy to go, oh, you know, I'm never going to feel good again. And that can go on for a long time. So just knowing that you can feel good again, but it might just be a different way. You'll get a buzz, but in a different way from stuff again. And not to give up and just, you know, all that sort of take it day by day. And, you know, life can be good.